Hey, hi everyone. Welcome back to another video on Java for Selenium. In this video, we'll mainly discuss interfaces in Java. So we'll discuss 3 points in this video: what is interface, how to write interface, and how to implement interface. So what is, some slide issue. So what is interface? So interface is a special kind of class which contains variable and which cannot be changed. So why it cannot be changed, we'll get to know into 2 to 3 minutes when we write the programs. It contains the method declaration only, not the method's body. So you can only declare the methods, you cannot write the body, because respective class has to write the body. In technical words, it has a static constant variables and abstracts method only. So what is the static constants and abstract method? Once you write the program, you will get to know. As of now, interface is a special kind of class itself, which have only the methods declaration, does not contain any body. And interface, whatever variables we will create, you cannot change their values because they are final static constant in nature. So how to write? You need to write one interface keyword, then interface name, you can keep the variables and you can keep the methods as well. So let me show you through program, but before moving to the program, let me draw a diagram, then you will get the importance of interface. Let's say we have one requirement, and this requirement says we need a specific calculator. In this calculator, you should have minimum addition method, subtraction method, and let's take multiplication as well. We will not write the body. We have created a dummy blueprint. Like, this interface has 3 methods, and now you need to write certain classes. So let's say we have a requirement. You need to design an advanced calculator. So even though you are creating advanced calculator, we know every calculator should have these 3 methods at least. This is the highly recommended requirement. Another requirement, we need to design a scientific calculator. Scientific calculator can also have multiple methods. So let's say scientific calculator may have 300 methods, but minimum they should have these 3 methods. They can override it based on the requirement, but they should have these 3 methods. In the same way, you can see advanced calculator can have 500 methods, but they should have minimum these 3 methods. And let's say I have one more calculator called EMI calculator. This EMI calculator have 100 methods, but minimum they should have these 3 methods, which is already specified by the interface. So you have to notice one thing, like using this interface, we have created a relationship between all these 3 classes, and we have clearly mentioned they can have their own methods, but they should have minimum these 3 methods, like addition, subtraction, and multiplication. They can write the body based on their requirement, but they should have these 3 methods, which is already defined by interface. We are not writing the body in the interface, but this is the requirement which says you need to implement these. Until you don't implement these methods, you cannot create object of your class itself. So why it has been introduced in WebDriver, we will discuss in next video. But as of now, let's take this development requirement. Your requirement is you need to create a calculator which can have multiple methods, but they should have minimum these 3 methods. So let me create a separate package, and this package name I will give interface demo. Here I will create one interface. So right click. So till now we have created multiple classes, but let's create an interface. Interface, I can give, let's say, calculator. I will say calci. So this calculator can have only the method declaration, method declaration, let's say add. Void subtraction. We cannot write the body. If you try to write the body here, Java will throw error. And if you put mouse over here, it will say abstract method, do not specify a body. It means we cannot write the body inside an interface. It can contain some variable as well. Let's say if I create one variable, say x equal to 10. So you can use this value inside the classes, but you cannot change this value. So let's say I have one class called advanced calculator. And the requirement is highly specific that you have to implement this calculator. Otherwise, this advanced calculator will not be valid. Since it's a requirement, I will write one keyword called implements, and then I will say calci. So when you say calci, it means you are implementing the calci interface, which has certain methods. So when you implement, Java will ask you, please add the unimplement methods. So if I click on this, it will create the dummy structure of the methods which is coming from the interface. So it's generating two methods and it will ask you to write the body. In interface, we had two methods, addition, subtraction. So we got these two methods. Now this class can have its own method. So let's say, since it's an advanced calculator, I will say calculate sine theta and calculate cos theta. Any name, any data, this is just a dummy code. You can remove this override. So this is mandatory, I have to write the body. So I will say I'm in addition method. I am in subtraction method. I am in advanced calci method, cos theta method. Same thing I will write for sine theta method. So this class has two methods, which is its own, and two methods are coming from the interfaces. And you can see, you will get a small arrow here which says these methods are coming from the interface which has been implemented by this particular class. Now again, you will get these four scenarios. So this is what we have done. We have implemented the calci interface in our child class. So whatever scenarios we have covered in inheritance, same scenarios will be applicable here. So let's take the first scenario. If I create child class reference and child class object, this will allow to access all the method of base class and child class. So in our case, advanced calculator is the child class. So if I create object of it, let's say obj1. obj1 dot addition I can call subtraction, I can call calculate sine theta and calculate cos theta. This is same as we have discussed in the last video. So if we are creating object of child class, which is advanced calculator, we are able to call all the method of base class, which is nothing but your interface, and child class method, which is these methods. So if I run this code, it will directly print all these because we are creating object of child class. Now let's take one more scenario. So I will create copy of it. So now we will try to get the second scenario, base class reference and child class object. This will allow to access all the method of base class only. So in our case, base class is calci. So if I say calci obj1 equal to new advanced calculator, you can see we can only access the base class method, which is nothing but your Kelsey interface. So you can only call these methods which is coming from the interface. So if I run this, you will get all the method of base class only. Now, if you give a small attention here, you will notice we cannot use third and fourth scenario. I will show you directly. So if I copy paste the certain code here and third scenario says, second scenario, which I forgot, I will implement now. Second scenario says, if I create a base class reference and base class object, this will allow to access all the method of base class only. So this scenario, which is coming from inheritance, right? But if you try to do the same thing here, Java will not allow you to create object of an interface. Here, what we are trying to do, we are creating object of an interface, and Java says you cannot create object of an interface. The reason is Java says until your class is not fully implemented. Fully implemented means every method should have a body. So interface does not even have a methods body, so we cannot create object of an interface. So this scenario is invalid. And if I take another scenario which says, if I create reference of base class, in our case it's advanced calculator 1, obj 2 equal to new Kelsey. This is again invalid because again we are trying to create object of an calculator, which is nothing but an interface. So Java again says you cannot create object of an interface because it has certain method which does not have even a body. And Java says you cannot create object of an interface because it has abstract method. What is abstract method? Abstract methods are those methods which does not have any body at all. So you have only two scenarios valid. Either you can create object of child class, which is nothing but advanced calculator. In this way, you can access all the method of base and child. Second scenarios, you can create reference of base class, object of child class. In that case, you can access all the method of base class. Third and fourth scenarios invalid. You cannot create object of the base class here because the base class here we have is the interface. And fourth scenario is again invalid. So now this comes to a final conclusion why WebDriver guys has created a separate interface. Now just try to assume Selenium guys has created one interface called WebDriver. This WebDriver have certain methods, let's say get to start a browser, close to quit the browser, get title to print the title of that particular page, find the element, and so on. They have not written the body because the respective class has to write the body. Now there's a separate class here called Android driver. So even they have separate way to write the code, they can write, because we are not writing the code, we are just giving a blueprint. So Selenium guys has given this condition. This Android driver can have 300 different methods, but they should have minimum these methods. Then only they can access the Selenium libraries. So they have this condition. Now let's say I have another class called Chrome driver. This Chrome driver can have 400 methods, but they should have minimum these methods which has been given by WebDriver, right? So like this, they have separate Firefox driver, Internet Explorer driver, and they have to write the body. And the reason why they have not written the body in the interface, because every vendor having a different implementation. So Chrome is coming from Google. So Google having a different way to start the browser, close the browser, so they will write the code accordingly. Again, Android is from the Google, so they have a separate way to start the Chrome browser in Android mobiles. In the same way, if you take iPhone driver or iOS driver, so iOS can have 700 methods, doesn't matter, but they should have minimum these methods which has been implemented, which has given by the web driver guys. So when they start using this interface, you will notice it doesn't matter which driver you will use, you will get all these methods minimum, which is really required. So that's the reason you are able to achieve cross-browser testing in Selenium. Doesn't matter which browser you're using, but the methods will remain same. So if you're not able to understand this WebDriver part, that's perfectly fine. But once you start Selenium, you have to relate this concept. Even you're using Chrome, IE, Firefox, Opera, Safari, WebDriver methods will remain same. So that is the reason why they have given WebDriver as an interface. WebDriver has given only the methods, and the respective class has to write the body. Now, before closing this video, in CalC, that is nothing but an interface, we have one thing called variable x equal to 10. So let me create a separate class. If I say advanced calculator 3. And this time I don't want to write all of this. If I say x equal to 90. So you can see here, if I try to write x equal to 90, this x is coming actually from the calculator. So already we have given 10 values. If you try to overwrite this value, Java will clearly give you one thing called final field cannot be assigned. It means you cannot change any value in the class, or in other words, you cannot change any variable which is coming from the interfaces. So if you give x1, then you can give it integer x1. But if you try to write x here, x is coming from the calculator, or you can say interface. So if you try to change the value, you cannot change, because by default all the variables in interface is final, and final value cannot be changed. This is another concept now. So final variables cannot be changed. So this is what I have for this video. Hope you understand the concept of interface, why they have added, and what is the usage of it. So the main, or you can say the main objective of creating interface, just to connect all these classes together so that they can share a common methods name which we can use across our Selenium test. So now you have a tight relationship between all of these, and you can start using it WebDriver in a normal way. So that's the reason you will always write in this way, WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver. It doesn't matter which browser you're using, you will get all the methods always same. So whenever you say Chrome driver, methods will remain same. Whenever you say IE driver, methods will remain same. Whenever you say Opera driver, it doesn't matter which browser you're using, but in the left hand side we have interface, right? So this driver will remain same, and you will get all the method of web driver which has been written by the Selenium guys. So that's all I have for this video. Thank you so much. If you still have any doubt, let me know. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.